Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Cafe Saigon 2017. My name is Lowell, and I will be one of your MCs tonight.
And my name is Tan. Thank you all for coming. Today, we have alumni in attendance from all over the country.
We are really happy to have you guys here. People that came from all over, our alumni from throughout the United States. We're really glad that you came here and have arrived safe and sound, especially if you flew United Airlines. All right, whatever.
This year's Cafe Saigon is celebrating the Cornell Vietnamese Association's 25th anniversary. Since 1992, even before Lo and I were born, CVA has been promoting the Vietnamese culture, heritage, and tradition throughout Cornell and the Ithaca area.
25 years is impressive. During that time, we've been able to develop relationships with organizations like the CFA, the Cornell Hawaii Club, and the Ithaca Waldorf School.
Our theme this year is Tôi là ai, who am I, which seeks to investigate our intersecting and overlapping identities.
As part of our reflection on our past, the first part of our program features our alumni looking back on their experiences at CVA and sharing with us their fondest memories. Please sit back and enjoy this video.
I'm Kimmy Pham. I was a CVA co-president from 2014 to 2015.
Hi, CVA. My name is Roselle, and I'm a Cornell alumna, class of 2014.
So, my name is Fung. I am graduate in 2017. I graduated in 2015.
Hi, my name is Sam Bui. I'm Cornell 2008. I was in CVA from freshman all the way to senior year. I majored in psychology.
Hi, my name is Holly Doe. I was a graduate from Cornell in 2010.
Some of my favorite CBA memories are the ones that we didn't even plan. So staying up till 2 a.m. to make dessert for Cafe Saigon the next morning, a late night trip to Wegmans, an impromptu meeting with Donna or Gibetti, trying to find a dance room for rehearsal, a band rehearsal that turns into a jam session, or making up a Taekwondo skit on the fly at Duffield Hall. All these sort of random, urgent, sometimes stressful situations led to really great bonding experiences and memories that I'll cherish.
So long story short, I joined CVA as a senior because at the time I was co-vice president of the Cornell Filipino Association, and it's been such a privilege to get to know some of the amazing people that I've met through CVA. They really inspire me with what they do, and they support me to this day, and it's something that you really can't find, or it's difficult to find outside of college.
And I was co-president of CVA my junior year with Jeffers, and I've been involved in CVA for 4 years of my college since the first day I arrived at Cornell, and I would be like, where are my Vietnamese people at? The 4 year I was at Cornell, the group that I was involved with the most was probably CVA. I would join so many clubs on campus, and even though I had no time for anything, I would spend so much time with CVA.
CVA was kind of my only way of getting to know Vietnamese people. When I was growing up in North Carolina, the only other Vietnamese family I really knew was my sister. So I didn't really have exposure to Vietnamese culture other than what my parents taught me. So it was nice to meet other people from around the world and to see that we all have something in common. It's the first time where I felt like I truly identified being a Vietnamese American.
I think I started on as a timid little freshman. I didn't really know what I was getting myself into, and somehow I got myself signed up to do all these dances and skits for the show, and I had a lot of fun, and I was really dedicated.
I like Ganjua. There's like fish heads in it. Has to have fish heads.
Yeah.
Don't take it too seriously. But don't party too hard. Find a middle ground. Yes.
Yeah.
From that touching reflection on the past, we'll move on to celebrating the children of the future. Through the years, our spirit of spreading the Vietnamese culture has led us to develop meaningful relationships with many organizations, such as the Ithaca Waldorf School.
So our next performance is the Ithaca Waldorf School, and they're here to perform the traditional fan dance with drumming accompaniment. All right. A fantastic performance. One of CVA's three pillars is cultural education, and it brings us great joy to share our traditions with the Ithaca Waldorf School, and we're inspired by their willingness to perform. The CVA band will sing a medley of two songs, Vai Lan Don Dua and Shape of You. Singing for us will be Tuyen Nguyen, Van Mai, Cuong Pham, and accompanying on the piano is Huang Vu.
Chiều nào bước chân vội
You've been to Vietnam, right?
Yeah.
Have you ever been to Hue?
No, I haven't.
Did you know that in Hue, there's this traditional dance used in imperial settings for many occasions, such as the king's birthday, the spring's festival, royal weddings and celebrations?
Wow, that sounds really interesting.
So now, without further ado, let's welcome the ladies from CVA as they bring us the traditional teacup dance.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for that wonderful performance. The next part of our program highlights one of Cornell University's international programs in Vietnam. Over the past 3 years, Cornell has increased its engagement with Vietnam. There is a ILR in Vietnam program, the director of which, Richard Fincher, is here. This program brings Cornellians to Ho Chi Minh City, where they study labor relations and alternative dispute resolution at Thon Duc Thanh University. Another program that Cornell has recently begun is the Climate Change in Vietnam program, whose director is also here. Co Thuy is here somewhere. And this past winter break, our co-president, Tiana, one of these very talented dancers, traveled to the Mekong Delta in southern Vietnam to study the effects of climate change on the environment and the people living there. She prepared a video for us that discusses her experiences in Vietnam and its influence upon her. Please enjoy.
I heard stories as a kid. I heard about Vietnam, its beauty, its people, and its culture. My parents described the beauty of Vietnam to me and how much their heritage meant to them. Their passion for Vietnamese culture influenced me to appreciate my identity and my family heritage. In college, my friends from the Cornell Vietnamese Association told me stories about Vietnam. They told me how much it was changing. And I concluded that I had to go see for myself. Cornell opened me to so many opportunities. If I had an interest, I knew I could find someone to help connect me to anything I was dreaming of. I was dreaming about Vietnam and what I could learn about it. One thing led to another, and I was enrolled in climate change awareness in Vietnam. It was the beginning of an insightful look into this massive world and even my own identity within it. I am a strong believer in the science behind climate change, so I pursued this opportunity to learn more about it. I believe climate change is real, and I'm sad to learn that it was impacting my parents' home country. In Ho Chi Minh City, I learned about some of Vietnam's history, especially about their past with the United States. At the War Remnants Museum, I was struck by the impacts of Agent Orange and how it hurt the lives of Vietnamese farmers in the Mekong Delta. Unfortunately, they still face these impacts today. Then my class and I traveled to Gan Yeo, where we visited the forefronts of the devastating impacts of climate change. I saw how the distribution of Agent Orange destroyed almost every living thing on the fertile lands of the Mekong Delta, like the mangroves that would normally perform as a fortress against coastal degradation. Agent Orange is not the Mekong Delta's only bully. Rising sea levels are moving into its fresh waters and canals, destroying farmlands that produce the abundant fruit, vegetables, and grains for Vietnam. Nicknamed the Rice Bowl of Vietnam, the Vietnamese people of the Mekong Delta take pride in farming fruitful crops, providing rice to the rest of the country. In Cần Thơ and Bến Tre, farmers and scientists are working quickly to find adaptations to changing climates. I met some local people and they told me about their home. They told me about the resourcefulness of coconut trees, the beauty of music from the Mekong Delta, and the varieties in the floating markets. They welcomed me and showed me a glimpse of their lives. They made the story of climate change personal, how it is impacting people right now. For the future, I'm looking forward to defining and redefining my dreams by exploring this beautiful, massive world.
But right now, we have a special part in our program where we're going to have three alumni from CVA come up and talk about their experiences and reflect on how CFA has impacted CVA. CVA has impacted their careers.
All right. So well, please welcome to the stage Melinda, Tim, and Jeffers.
So we'd like for each of you to introduce yourselves, and then we'll ask you some questions.
Hi, my name's Jeffers. I was at Cornell from 2011 to 2015, and I've been involved in CVA all 4 years, and I was co-president in 2013 to 2014.
Hi, my name is Tim. I was at Cornell 2009 to 2013, information science major, and I was also involved in CVA all 4 years.
Hi everyone, my name is Melinda and I was a graduate of 2015 like Jeffers. Of course involved all 4 years, I think that's a testament to why we're here today. This is actually just, I'm just like reminiscing right now because my first 3 years I was MC, so like this is like what I got to see at Cafe Saigon, and so it's super super cool to just be back as an alum and to like feel just as awesome right now as I did when I was here, you know, 65432 years ago. And yeah, thanks for bringing us up. We're really excited to be here with everybody.
So we'd like to ask you, what is your fondest memory with CVA?
No, it's fine. You don't gotta do the ladies first thing.
Okay. My fondest memory, so I think it was my freshman year. We held the culture show in PSB, the physical science building. And we have this tradition in CVA where we take a pan of whipped cream and then we pie one of our members. And one of our members, his name is Ankit, he was sitting on the chair wearing like a little cloth thing.
That's a nice squat you got going on there.
And they went to go pie him, but then he ducks and the pie flies into the wall, stains the wall. We're permanently banned from PSB, and we're charged $2,000. But we made it out, and it was pretty funny.
You know, that was actually gonna be my story, but now I think of something else.
My favorite moment is making the CVA videos. It was like a lot of work. We put a lot of all-nighters editing the videos and making sure that everything's up to par. But I find that even though it's a lot of work, when you spend that time with good friends, it creates like very like everlasting memories, I would say. And then graduating two, three years later, looking back, it always brings back really good memories, even to today.
Okay, so I guess one of my fondest memories was that pieing, because we were just trying to have some fun, and then now we can't go back to that building ever again. But I guess fondest memories, besides being able to partake in creating this culture show, I think something that it was like a tagline, CVA love, that we used to just pass around all the time. And you really feel it the most when you're creating these culture shows, because you spend endless hours doing things that you otherwise would never stay up till 4 or 5 a.m. doing, and like you don't regret it at all. And I think that's a really amazing thing about this this organization being able to create. And then the other thing is, this is gonna sound super cheesy, but I think my fondest memories will be the ones to come, because this right here is just like amazing to me to be able to see these guys again and like we're on, you know, different ends of the coast, and it's just like, it's another way that you really get to come back and like call it home and like be with each other. A lot of people leave Cornell and they don't have a reason to come back unless it's like, you know, homecoming or like a reunion. And so this is like the most awesome thing I could ask for.
Okay, so thank you for sharing your experience with us.
Thank you very much. It's always nice to hear our alumni's experiences. So our next performance is by Quintessence, a group of very talented CVA singers.
So they will be performing a medley of Lời Yêu Thương, Quê Hương Việt Nam, and Sài Gòn Đẹp Lắm.
Ngày nhột nhịp về trên khu phố, các cô em tung tăng đôi môi cười hoa thắm. Và mặt trời của miền yên tâm trên vai em buông lời cho anh mơ. Anh muốn được cùng em về vùng biển vắng. Mình sẽ sống những ngày hè ấm nắng dưới bóng dừa là lời. Sẽ nói yêu em mãi, sẽ nói lời yêu thương đã từ lâu ôm ấp trong lòng hoài. Down the way when the lights are gray and the sun shines only on the mountain top. I took a trip on a sailing ship. When I reached Cayuga, I made a stop. Mai muốn được cùng em về vùng biển vắng. Mình sẽ sống những ngày hè ấm nắng dưới bóng dừa là lời. Sẽ nói yêu em mãi, sẽ nói lời yêu thương đã từ lâu ôm ấp trong lòng hoài. Khi anh nắng lên, gió khe đôi trên bông lúa xanh, và tình yêu trong em có em gần bên anh. Dù rằng anh đưa em qua tháng năm ở nơi đây trong ngày mến thương, vì là yêu lắm ôi quê hương Việt Nam. Một rừng rậm muôn hoa thắm tươi, khắp nơi nơi rộn ràng tiếng cười, và sáng mang theo khát khao màu đang mơ.
Việt Nam ơi, Sài Gòn Việt Nam tôi vẫn ở đây. Hà Nội anh em bao nhiêu bạn bè thân lắm, bao nhiêu con người cười tôi nụ cười. Ba bài ca ha, hai vàng chung một nhà. Dù đi nơi nào cũng chẳng thấy mình như xa thật xa. Qua bao nhiêu năm, qua bao nhiêu kiếp người, bao nhiêu con người đã qua, bao nhiêu nụ cười trẻ thơ như hoa mới nở, bao nhiêu con người tắt thở, bao nhiêu con người tiếp nối. Hẹn cả ông tôi ra xuống đất, ba con người được nuôi nấng. Hôm 4.000 năm giờ đây ta về đây.
Ông nhìn vào mấy khi anh nắng lên, gió khe đưa trên bông lúa xanh, và tình yêu trong tim có em gần bên anh.
Được bên nhau nhé.
Rồi mà anh đưa em qua tháng năm, ở nơi đây tràn đầy mến thương, gửi lời yêu lắm ôi quê hương Việt Nam.
Việt Nam, Việt Nam yo.
Tắt thoáng một tà áo tung bay, nếp sóng môi tươi đón chân tôi đến nơi đây. Sài Gòn đẹp lắm, Sài Gòn ơi, Sài Gòn ơi. Tình yêu mến khi lời hát câu ca, để lòng thương nhớ bao người vắng nơi xa. Không ai chúng tôi vắng hôm nay sẽ không phải. Sài Gòn đẹp lắm, Sài Gòn ơi, Sài Gòn ơi. La 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 la, tiếng cười cùng gió chan hòa niềm vui say sưa. La 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 la, la 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 la, ôi đời đẹp quá chan mây thơ. La 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 la, la 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 la, tiếng cười cùng gió chan hòa niềm vui say sưa. La 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 la, la 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 la, ôi đời đẹp quá chan mây thơ. Đẹp quá, chẳng bao ý thơ.
Now, the next part of our program, one of the most exciting parts of the evening, our fashion show.
So, as you may have known or seen, the Vietnam's national dress, the Áo Dài, consists of two elements, a long tunic with a close-fitting bodice, mandarin color, raglan sleeves, and side slits that create front and back panels from the waist down, and wide-legged pants often cut on the bias.
The Áo Dài provides a striking example of how Vietnamese have responded to both Chinese and French influence by adopting elements of foreign cultures and modifying them to be uniquely Vietnamese.
The original Áo Dài was by no means the symbol of aesthetics. The garment was plain and loosely fitted, unflattering to the female body.
Nowadays, the Áo Dài has many variations compared with the Áo Dài in the past. However, it has always kept its traditional features that flatter the decency, discreetness, and harmony for those who wear it.
So now, please make way as the models make their way down the runway.
Yeah, please ensure that these two aisles are clear. Thank you very much. that certainly puts my fashion sense to shame.
So the fashion show featured a lot of different types of aoyais. You see traditional ones, the more modern ones, the wedding ones, and then also the ones that you wear during Lunar New Year.
Can you tell us about your aoyai?
So my aoyai, the tunic, actually is my high school uniform. So a girl from my high school won Miss Aoyai contest in Vietnam. So we were awarded with the fabric with our school logo on it. And I just paired it with like blue pants because like it looks nice with the logo. And then you also saw in the aoyai there was one that's like all white. That's our high school uniform. Depends on the school, but usually we have to wear it every Monday to school.
That's a very elegant uniform. I can only imagine what it would be like to have those aoyai up above Cayuga's waters, per se. Anyway, moving on, we're going to continue with a CVA tradition, which is one of our parody videos. So we'll set that up. Yeah. Please enjoy.
Mrs. Hudson.
Yes, Sherlock?
This is hard.
Have you been getting into Mr. Hudson's Cialis stash?
No, it's harder.
Harder than Theresa May's Brexit negotiations?
Yes, hardest thing I've ever done.
Are you kidding me, Sherlock? Life is hard. I'm here alone, knitting like a Nike factory worker, living off government subsidies and waiting for the Tories to cut out my lifeline, while Theresa May and the Tories just want to leave the European Union. Stronger together, I say.
For a good CVA video idea, and what a better story than the Chime Master's idea.
I think someone's stalking me. I've used a Taurus as part of the job, but this is different. Someone's watching me. He's taking pictures of me every day.
This was all about distracting me so that this man could get in here and take my wallet.
Ukraine. Hold on. Something's wrong.
What's wrong?
Don. Look at the sign.
My ID's missing.
Well, it's gonna expire in 6 months anyway.
We never found the Chime Master's ID. In frustration and in preparation for Cafe Saigon, John and I decided to go on a coffee crawl. Let's just say it didn't end very well. Despite being high on coffee, we never shy away from them just in case, which leads us well into the Mayfly friend.
I think I went to an event with a ghost. What is he doing?
He's clearing for looks. I mean, looking for clues.
Once we've sobered up, John and I decided to investigate the people that the Mayfly friend had interacted with. Hi.
Sharon.
Jonathan.
Tiana.
What event were you at?
CVA's death celebration.
Asian night.
Apple Fest.
Type of phone?
iPhone 6S.
Galaxy S6.
Motorola Razr.
Do you have any secrets on your phone?
No.
Gotcha.
Wait, Sherlock. What do you mean?
Everyone has secrets. They all reply too quickly.
Well, gotta go.
Bye.
Sorry, dear.
Enjoy the culture show. Culture show, culture show, culture show.
Lock this place down. Narrow it down. Narrow it down. Narrow it down.
Greetings. In case the video is too confusing, my name is Sherlock Holmes. And this is my colleague, Mr. John Watson. So from my, using my mind palace and my deductive reasoning skills, I have concluded that the Mayfly friend is in this building, in this room, tonight. But we don't have sufficient evidence to find the identity of this Mayfly friend, but we have to find out who he's targeting. Obviously, John, this is someone who is very important. Someone that he can only get to at an event like this. Any ideas? Chibetti. Please, can you come on stage? Now I would like to invite the CVA co-presidents, Tiana and Van Ha, to come up on stage. Thank you. Yes.
Hi, everyone. So Chibetti is one of our co-advisors for CVA. She's the one that does the choreography for the teacup dance. Whenever we are organizing an event, she always tells us what looks good and what doesn't. She's definitely the fashionista for CVA. All the decorations in this room is her vision, making NUU's vision. And she's actually leaving this fall. She will be going on to California. We just wanted to thank you for all that you've done for CVA. We have a gift for you. Thank you so much for everything that you do. We're really going to miss you.
Chibetti, it's so hard to see you go. You've been an amazing contributor to this community and not only to the Cornell community and the Ithaca College community, but also to the Ithaca Waldorf School. I want to thank you so much for bringing culture to them and being so open, and the children have something that they would like to present to you. Come on up, please. On behalf of the children of the Ithaca Waldorf School, this is something for your new home, and we hope that you will cherish it for years to come and think about the children in your new home in California. Monterey's gain is our loss. I will miss you tremendously. Thank you so much.
I'm feeling.
Thank you so much, Tibeli, for being our advisor. And we'd also like to thank Donna, who's also our other advisor. Can you please come up to the stage? We have something for you too.
So we also would like to thank Anfong and Ang Tu for all their enduring support in helping us organize and conceptualize this event. Thank you very much. We also have something else for you. And of course, probably the central and most important person to thank for tonight is our cook, the person that conceptualized the food that you have all enjoyed. So An Tai, can you please come up on stage? And we'd like to welcome on the alumni that shared their experiences. So Tim and Jeffers, please come up on stage. We'd like to thank all the performers. If you perform, please come up on the stage.
Tao về tao tắm áo ra, đục hay trong nhiều gần hay xa vẫn là nhà. Ngôi sao ở giữa được.